साथियों, आज का भारत नया भारत है, बदला हुआ भारत है, लेकिन अब कोई भारत को आंख दिखाने का साहस नहीं कर सकता।
The Iron Man, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, was instrumental in uniting a fractured and divided India, wherein the armed forces played a crucial role in its unification, integration, and the protection of its interests. To induct, to become Atmanirbhar, to innovate is the dictum our armed forces follow as they protect it. India's newly formed Department of Military Affairs, headed by the Chief of Defence Staff, has tremendously enhanced efficiency and effectiveness of the planning process through intra and inter-service prioritization. Our Air Force has gone through significant upgradation with the induction of the Omni-role Rafale, the Apache attack helicopters, and the heavy-lift helicopter Chinook. The homegrown LCA Tejas has been integrated in all operational roles. The advanced light helicopter Dhruv is emerging as a versatile platform. The airborne early warning and control planes bridge a critical gap in India's defense preparedness. Our naval fleet stands strengthened with the inclusion of the Kalbari submarine and the Arihant submarine, which operates underwater over long distances for months. The Kolkata-class destroyers and Nilgiri-class frigates ensure that India's maritime boundaries and interests remain secure. The aircraft carrier INS Vikrant is undergoing sea trials. The B-8I is equipped for long-range anti-submarine warfare, anti-surface warfare and ISR. On land, the Army's arsenal now includes the ultra-light howitzer, a game-changer on the battlefield. The new Vajra K9 self-propelled artillery gun fires 47-kilogram bombs at distances up to 43 kilometers. And the Arjun main battle tank that wreaks havoc on any battlefield. India's elite special forces are more lethal than ever with the induction of a new long-range sniper rifle and pistols. The anti-tank Nag missile has a single-shot kill probability of 90% that strikes terror in the heart of any opponent. The helicopter-launched version of the Nag missile, Helena, and its Air Force variant, Dhruvastra, are now undergoing joint user trials. The BrahMos, Rudram and Astra missiles have been integrated with Sukhoi 30 MKI. Developed by DRDO, Akash and MR-SAM missiles can target aircraft at long ranges. The rapid induction of new technology in the armed forces is thus being complemented by indigenous equipment under the vision of an Atmanirbhar Bharat. What gives Indian ingenuity an edge is our unique aptitude for innovation. Developed jointly by the Indian Army and DRDO for close quarters combat, the ASMI submachine gun will prove to be decisive in counter-insurgency operations. Indigenously developed microcopters carry out effective surveillance even inside enemy-occupied structures. Switch tactical drones help monitor and direct battlefield operations in real time, even in high altitude areas like Ladakh. The advent of swarm drone technology means India is poised to enter a new paradigm in aerial warfare. Complementing the fighters of the IAF will be the warrior drones under CATS, a composite amalgamation of manned and unmanned platforms. Shakti is the world's first universal bulletproof jacket, which can be used by both male and female combatants. Developed by the Indian Navy, the Navaraksha PPE is low-cost and breathable and is protecting people across the globe. Moving from the necessities of grassroots innovation to the revolutionary idea of Atmanirbhar Bharat, and thence on to an India that makes for the world, we are realizing the vision of the Prime Minister. The LCA Tejas, Akash, BrahMos and Astra weapons systems are already in high demand from countries across the globe. India's vision towards empowering the defense through induction, Atmanirbhar Bharat and innovation ensures that those who dare to look across our borders will need to think twice. Jai Hind!